We were doing exercise chapter number 4, exercise 4.3 was going on. I think we have finished up to question number 3rd and 4th question is to be started. Purval, is it like this? Okay. So we are going to start with question number 4. Question number 4, exercise 4.3. So what the question is, now we will do some word problems, or you can say statements based on the linear equation in two variables. And we'll see that how to make a linear equation in two variables with the help of the given information. So let us start. Question number 4. Taxi fare in a city is as follows. For the first kilometer, the fare is rupees 8. For first kilometer, fare is rupees 8, right? And for the subsequent distance, it is rupees 5 per kilometer. For subsequent distance, the fare is rupees 5 per kilometer, right? For subsequent distance, the fare is rupees 5 per kilometer. Taking the distance covered as x and fare as y, write a linear equation in two variables, represent it through graph as well. So one thing I want to tell you, in exam, it's not necessary that it will be given to you that you have to take the fare as x and total rupees as y. This is given in the question, but in exam, you have to take it yourself, right? So I told you that whenever there is a linear equation in two variables, problem sum, just try to understand, just try to take two things which are unknown in the questions, involved unknown in the question, so that we can assign them to variables. For example, if I'm talking about this question, one is the distance, kilometers. This is a distance, you can say in the kilometer, in terms of kilometer distance is given. Another is in terms of rupees, that is fare is given, right? So what we will do, और सबसे पहली बात ये कि जब भी हमने इनको लेट करना है वेरिएबल्स को, वी विल लेट द टोटल क्वांटिटी, बिकॉज डिस्टेंस एंड फेयर टोटल क्वांटिटी में हमारे पास काउंट होगा कि टोटल कितना डिस्टेंस, टोटल कितना फेयर. सो आई एम गोइंग टू राइट, लेट एक्स किलोमीटर विद अ टोटल डिस्टेंस, विद अ टोटल डिस्टेंस टू बी कवर्ड and y rupees be the total fare. Maine let kiya, what is given in the question, still I'm assuming it, reason being because sometimes in exam it is not given, we have to let them, we have to suppose them ourselves. So x kilometer is a total distance and rupees y be the total fare for the given condition. Now can anyone tell me the dictionary meaning of the word subsequent? What is the meaning of subsequent? All people, English people, English men are sitting in front of me. So very good in English, Gurpal Singh. Let me ask Gurpal, what is the meaning of subsequent?
Ma'am, usse aage wale.
Usse aage wala, haan, kaha ja sakta hai. Anyone else? Anyone else who can tell me the dictionary meaning of the word subsequent? Anshia? Anshia, can you tell me the dictionary meaning of the word subsequent? Subsequent.
I'm next.
Next.
I'm usse next.
Yes, repeat.
I'm next. Usse.
Next. हाँ, next भी कह सकते हैं, उससे आगे वाला. गुरपाल ने बोला उसके आगे वाला और next. Anyhow, so let me tell you subsequent.
मैम उस आने वाले, उसके आगे आने
वाले. आगे वाला, बिल्कुल ठीक. यहाँ पे I would like to take it as remaining. आपने next बोला, मैंने बोला remaining. बचा हुआ, इससे आगे वाला ही बचा होगा ना. Remaining. Subsequent का meaning I am taking it to be remaining. Next भी इसका meaning वही है. Next का मतलब यही कि आगे वाला distance. इसी तरह से subsequent भी हम word को remaining की तरह यूज कर सकते। अब जब एक पर्सन ट्रेवल कर रहा है उसको नेचुरली फेयर पे करना पड़ेगा, कोई अपनी को बसेज अपने ऑटो तो चल नहीं रहे कि हम किसी भी ऑटो में जाके बैठ जाए और हमसे वो पैसे मिले, राइट? तो फेयर इज टू बी पेड। सो व्हेन द टैक्सी ड्राइवर ही हैज मेड सम, यू कैन से प्लान सम रूल फॉर गेटिंग द फेयर फ्रॉम द पैसेंजर्स, बट रूल ही इज अप्लाइंग, ही सेज व्हेरेवर यू आर गोइंग ही लीस्ट बॉदर वेदर यू आर गोइंग टू Maksuda Road or whether you are going to Nukodar Chowk. He is just telling you that for the first kilometer you have to pay rupees 8. First kilometer ke liye aapne rupees 8 pay karne hi hai. Theek hai? So, solution shuru karte hain hum. Yahan se aapka solution start hai. Ye maine information likhi thi given. Let X be the total distance to be covered and Y be the total fare. Fare for first kilometer. Rupees 8. Subsequent distance. Subsequent distance. See, this is the total distance x. I'm making a line. X kilometer. Out of this x kilometer, this is a question of 7th standard. Ab aap khud dekhna. Out of this x kilometer, 1 kilometer is being traveled. 1 kilometer have been traveled. So how much is left? If out of x kilometer, 1 kilometer person have traveled, so what is left? Yes, Jia? Speak up. Yes, Jia? Give the answer.
X minus 1.
Exactly.
X minus 1.
X minus 1 kilometer. Whatever is left, that is x minus 1 kilometer. So when I'm writing subsequent distance, it means I'm talking about x minus 1 kilometer. This is x minus 1 kilometer. Subsequent distance is x minus 1 kilometer. Right? Now, whatever subsequent distance is left, it doesn't mean that he is not going to charge any fare for the from the passenger. Usne first kilometer ka le liya aur baki aap aise hi ghoom lo, sara share ghoom lo chahe. Nahi. Subsequent distance ke liye bhi he is charging the fare as rupees 5 per kilometer. Jitne bhi kilometer ye hain. If it is 9, then multiply by 5, 40 is to be paid. If it is 10, 10 into 5, 50 is to be paid. If it is 40, 40 into 5, 200 is to be paid. So if it is x minus 1 kilometer, so you will write, therefore, subsequent distance at the rate of 5 per kilometer is equal to fare for the subsequent distance at the rate of 5 per kilometer. Itne kilometers hain, har ek kilometer ke liye 5, to itne kilometers ke liye kitna ho jayega? 5 into x minus. See, is it okay? This is the fare for the first kilometer, this is the fare for the subsequent distance, but the bacha hua distance. Right? Now, you know, we need to form an equation. So, to form an equation, we need some rule or some clue so that we can get left hand side and right hand side. This is the fare. We are talking about fare. And when we are traveling from somewhere to the another place, what we have to give? We have to give the total fare, right? So, total fare, we take it to be in our assumption as y. Y is the total fare. You can see in starting, I assume, let Y rupees be the total fare. So I'm writing it. Dekho, very cleverly, I make an equation which is having left hand side and right hand side and sign of equality there. Now, how the total fare will be formed? When the fare of first kilometer, it is added to the fare of the subsequent distance, we will get the total fare. This is the fare of the first kilometer. This is the fare for the subsequent distance. When these two will be added, we are getting the total fare as y. We want to make a linear equation in two variables. So let us solve it. We will be having 8 plus 5x minus 5 is equal to 1. 5 goes inside, get multiplied. So you will be having 5x, 8 minus 5, 3 is equal to y. This is the relation between the total fare and the total distance according to the given question. Is it okay? Gopal Singh, is it okay? You are switching your video on, so that's why I'm asking you. Chalo. Next, what he says, write a linear equation for the information we are writing, we have done, and also draw its graph. Coming to the next point, that we will draw its graph. You know, to draw the graph, we need points. To find the points, we need solution. And where those solutions are to be situated, we have to make a table. And with the help of the table, we will plot those points on the graph and we'll get the picture of the graph, right? So let us start with this equation as 5x plus 3 is equal to 1. So I'm making a table giving the values of x and corresponding values of y. Now, I used to tell you, yesterday I told you in the previous lecture that whenever you are going to draw a graph of an equation, you must take x is equal to 0 and get y, and you must take y equal to 0 and get x. And I told you at the same time that sometimes, according to the situation, we have to deal. Now, in this situation, we will not take x to 0. Because it is not possible that the person will cover distance and will not have money. Does it ever happen? ऑटो वाले ने हमें घुमाया भी नहीं और हमने कहा कि ये लो पैसे, नो हमारे पास इतने पैसे नहीं. और ऐसा कभी हो सकता है कि फेयर कुछ भी ना हो और डिस्टेंस आप कवर करते जाओ, या फिर डिस्टेंस कुछ भी ना हो फेयर देते जाओ. यानी कि हम यहाँ पे x इज इक्वल टू जीरो एंड y इक्वल टू जीरो वाली जो अपनी हमने एक रूल बनाया था उससे बाहर आ जाते हैं, उसको हम नहीं फॉलो करते क्योंकि फेयर भी जीरो पॉसिबल नहीं है और डिस्टेंस भी जीरो पॉसिबल नहीं है. So I'm leaving x is equal to 0 and y is equal to 0. Let us take x to be 1. X ko maan liya. First, yahan pe x ko 1 put kar do. You will get y to be 8. So x 1, y 8. Second, putting x to be 2. Let x is equal to 1. X is equal to 2. This is plus 3 equal to y. 10 plus 3 is equal to y. And 13 is equal to y. 2 and 13. Let us take x to be 3. So we will be having 5 into 3 plus 3 is equal to y. That is 15 plus 3 is equal to y. That is 18 is equal to y. Taking x to be equal to 4. This is 5 into 4 plus 3 is equal to y. That is 20 plus 3 is equal to y. That is 23 is equal to y. So 4. So these are the values of x and corresponding value of y, which we have find out by using the concept of solutions, putting the solution in the table, getting the point. Let us draw them on the graph to get the picture of the graph. So to draw the graph, you know, we need x-axis and y-axis. Perpendicular axis. Let us make them x-axis. We say tilted value. This is x-axis. X-axis. This is y-axis. This is your origin. Negative are not to be made because no, neither distance nor fear can be negative. So that's why I'm not having the negative direction of the axis, right? So along x, the variation of the points number is from 1 to 4. So taking 1, 2, 3, 4 at the proper distance, 10, 10K block pe baad aap 1, 2, 3, 4 mark kar lo apne graph pe. And here if you see, 8, 13, 20, 18 and 23. That means there are so many values varying from smaller value is 8 and the bigger value is 23. You can take the distance of 10. Along x-axis, x you are taking. And what was x? Distance in kilometer. Distance in kilometer. You have to write. And along y-axis, you are taking fare. So write down fare in rupees. Fare in rupees. So let us plot the graph. First point is 1 and 8. Starting with 1, counting the 8 lines, you will reach here. This is 1, 8. Second point is 2, 13. 10, after 10, 3 lines are to be counted. This is 2, 13. And after that, 3, 18. That means you have to count 8 lines after 10. This will be 3, 18. And after that, the fourth point is 423. 4, after 23 lines are to be counted. 423. Now join these lines, these points. So this is a graph of the linear equation. So write down the scale. Scale along x-axis and along y-axis. If I'm talking about scale along x-axis, you can see one block represents 1 kilometer. And along y-axis, one block represents 10 rupees. So this is the graph of the given equation. Now, one thing more I want to add up here. Sometimes the question is, also find the fare when the distance covered is 100 kilometers. Also find the fare when the distance covered is 100 kilometers. That means what we have to do? We have to replace x by 100 and we have to find the corresponding value of y. Similarly, if he says also find the fare when the distance covered is 200, that means you have to replace x by 200 and you have to find the corresponding value of y. Right? So, this is all about this question. Taxi fare wala question. Very famous question. We'll do some extra question of the same category. When the paper used to come from board, these kind of questions, they are the master question for the paper, right? Chaliye. Fifth question, apne aap graph ki reading and all that I'm not going to discuss apne aap karna. Sixth question I'm going to start. Statements sum ho gaye hamare ab sare start. Question number 6. Sixth question. But the question is, let us read out the statement. If the work done by a body on application of constant force is constant, that means force is fixed, is directly proportional to the distance traveled by the body, express this in the form of an equation in two variables. Pehle itna question padhenge hum. Express it in the form of equation in two variables. Work done is directly proportional to the distance. Right? Work done is directly proportional to the distance. You know, if I write it simply, sign of proportionality say, so it becomes work done, this is a sign of proportion, direct proportion to the distance. I used to take the distance as D. Work done is directly proportional to the distance. Work done is directly proportional to the distance. Hanji Jiya Janmi, what do you want to say? Hanji, JJ sister, bolo bete.
Ma'am, aapne ek triangle ka fifth question karwaya tha.
Kya fifth question kya?
Ma'am, aapne triangles ka, ma'am, jab aapne triangles ka fifth question karwaya tha, usme aapne PQ greater than PR wala karwaya tha, lekin question mein PR greater than PQ likha hua hai.
Bete, maine change kar diya tha last mein jab solution nahi ban raha tha, I had changed. Ab dekhna dhyan se. फिर भी अगर कोई प्रॉब्लम हुई आई विल सेंड द रिटन सॉल्यूशन. हां जी जिया जानवी ओके
ओके मैम
मैंने चेंज कर दिया था उसी टाइम पे. क्योंकि सॉल्यूशन में प्रॉब्लम आ रही थी. इफ देयर इज एनी प्रॉब्लम आई विल सेंड यू द रिटन सॉल्यूशन. अभी पहले ये कर लें, ये इस पे कॉन्सेंट्रेट करो. वर्क डन इज डायरेक्टली प्रोपोर्शनल टू द डिस्टेंस कवर्ड. एज वी आर गोइंग टू मेक द लीनियर इक्वेशन इन टू वेरिएबल, सो वी हैव टू चूज सर्टेन वेरिएबल फॉर द वर्क डन एंड फॉर द डिस्टेंस. सो वी राइट, ये तो सिर्फ एक मैंने आउटपुट उठाया क्वेश्चन का कि आउटपुट क्या है. वर्क डन इज डायरेक्टली प्रोपोर्शनल टू डिस्टेंस, सो यू विल राइट लेट वाई बी द वर्क डन. And x be the distance covered. X be the distance covered. Y be the work done and x be the distance covered. हमें दो वेरिएबल, मैंने पहले बताया दो चीजें आपको उठानी पड़ेंगी क्वेश्चन में से. एक को यू हैव टू टेक इट एज y कोऑर्डिनेट, अनदर यू हैव टू टेक इट एज x कोऑर्डिनेट. सो टू थिंग्स वी हैव टेकन अप, वन इज वर्क डन, अनदर इज द डिस्टेंस. Now, work done, according to question, work done is directly proportional to distance. That means y is direct proportion to x. Y is direct proportion to x. अगर inverse proportion हो तो 1 by x होता है, आपको याद होगा आपने किया हुआ है. So ये direct proportion है, so this will be x. Inverse में 1 by x हो जाता है, right? चलिए. So y is direct proportion to x. And in the previous classes, you learned that whenever we remove the sign of proportion, there comes a constant of proportion. जैसे ही हम proportionality का sign हटाते हैं, constant of proportion आ जाता है. And according to this question, constant of proportion is the force which is acting upon the body. So I'm taking it to be F. जैसे ही प्रोपोर्शनलिटी का साइन हटा, इक्वल टू का साइन आया, देयर इज अ कांस्टेंट ऑफ प्रोपोर्शन एंड अकॉर्डिंग टू क्वेश्चन वी हैव टू टेक इट टू बी एफ. सो वाई इज इक्वल टू एफ एक्स, दिस बिकम्स द इक्वेशन फॉर द गिवन प्रॉब्लम. इतना क्वेश्चन हमारा कंप्लीट हुआ. लेट अस रीड इट फर्दर. व्हाट ही वांट्स टू से, एक्सप्रेस इट इन द फॉर्म ऑफ इक्वेशन दैट वी डिड. Draw the graph of the same by taking the constant force to be 5 units. What he says, taking f to be 5, that means equation becomes y is equal to 5x. Y is equal to 5x is the equation. And using this equation, we have to draw the graph of the given using f to be 5. Right? So, you know, whenever we have to make the graph, what we need to do? We have to draw a table of values of x and y. So let me make that table. यहाँ पे याद रखना, मैं इधर लिख देती हूँ. I am taking f to be 5 according to question. Work done is directly proportional to distance. Constant of proportion, जैसे जैसे proportionality का sign हटता है, constant of proportion आता है and that is given to be f in the question. चलिए. So I am going to make the table according to y is equal to 5x. First, याद रखना ये हमारा वर्क डन है एंड दिस इज आवर डिस्टेंस एक्स इज डिस्टेंस टू एक्स वाई. एक्स जीरो वाई जीरो, पुट एक्स इज इक्वल टू जीरो, y is equal to 5x, so y comes out to be 0. Actually, मैंने 0 इसलिए लिया क्योंकि इसने 0 के accordingly question पूछा होगा. That's why. Second, put x is equal to 1. We get y is equal to 5 into 1, 5. Then, put x is equal to 2. Y is equal to 5 into 2. That is equal to 10. Then, put x is equal to 3. Put x is equal to 3, y is equal to 5 into 3, that is 15. Four values are sufficient, 2, 10 and 3, 15. This way I have made the table bana liya. X and y ki values ko represent karta hua ek achha sa table hamare samne yahan pe aa gaya. Right? चलो लेट अस ड्रॉ द ग्राफ सेम वी नीड एक्स एक्सिस पॉजिटिव डायरेक्शन वाई एक्सिस इट्स पॉजिटिव डायरेक्शन देन ओरिजिन अलोंग एक्स एक्सिस वी हैव टू टेक एक्स वेरिएबल एक्स की वैल्यू 0 से 3 तक वेरी कर रही है एंड व्हाट एक्स रिप्रेजेंट एक्स रिप्रेजेंट दिस यूनिट से कुछ नहीं बताए हुए हम ऐसे यूनिट लिखते हैं दिस यूनिट ठीक है एंड y represent the work done, so that is along y axis. देखो 5-5 का डिफरेंस है तो ऐसे ही ले लो 5, 10, 15 दिस इज योर वर्क डन ऑन y axis वर्क डन सो लेट अस मेक द ग्राफ फर्स्ट पॉइंट इज 0, 0 स्टार्टिंग विद द ओरिजिन 0, 0 देन 1, 5 देन 2, 10 This is 2, 10, then 3, 15, and then join. This is a graph. So how to write a scale along x-axis and then along y-axis. Along one axis, along x-axis, one block is equal to one unit distance. हमें नहीं पता यूनिट उसने क्या लिया हुआ है. And along y-axis, the force is 5A. So this is the graph of the given situation. Hope it is clear to all of you, right? So let us start with question number 7. Yamini and Fatima, they are the two students of a school of class 9, together contributing rupees 100 towards Prime Minister Relief Fund to help the earthquake victims. यामिनी एंड फातिमा दे आर वेरी गुड चिल्ड्रन दे वॉन्ट कि हम अर्थक्वेक विक्टिम की कुछ हेल्प करें बेचारे उनके पास ज्यादा पैसे नहीं थे तो उन दोनों ने इकट्ठे करके 100 rupees उनके पास इकट्ठा हुआ एंड दे वॉन्ट इट टू डिपॉजिट इन द प्राइम मिनिस्टर रिलीफ फंड राइट सो मेक एन इक्वेशन विद दिस इंफॉर्मेशन एंड ड्रॉ द ग्राफ अच्छा पिछले क्वेश्चन में एक चीज राइट उसने पूछा था वट इज द डिस्टेंस ट्रेवल्ड बाय द बॉडी वट इज द डिस्टेंस travel by the body yeah distance what is the distance traveled by body if nahi sorry what is the work done by the body If the distance is 2 units, अगर x 2 है तो y की वैल्यू कितनी है फर्स्ट सब आंसर हम क्या लिखेंगे y is equal to 5 into 2 that is 10 उसने बोला फ्रॉम द ग्राफ आप ग्राफ से भी देख सकते हो फिर अगर उसने ग्राफ से बोला तो आप उसको पॉइंट आउट करके आओगे इसका मतलब x 2 y 10 कौन सा पॉइंट है ये यहाँ पे डॉट लगा दो डॉटेड लाइन लगा फ्रॉम ग्राफ इट इज क्लियर दैट व्हेन x is equal to 2 that means distance is 2 then work done is 10 unit and second part is what is the work done when the distance is 0 unit here our point from the graph it is clear that the work done when the distance is 0 unit is 0 unit ग्राफ से अगर आ जाता है पेपर में तो वो पॉइंट आपका ग्राफ पे प्लॉट जरूर होना चाहिए नहीं तो मार्क्स ही मिलेंगे कुछ बच्चे क्या करते हैं मान लो उसने बोला व्हाट इज द वर्क डन व्हेन द डिस्टेंस कवर्ड इज 4 यूनिट फ्रॉम द ग्राफ बच्चे क्या करते हैं एक्स को 4 पुट करके वाई की वैल्यू 20 आंसर लिख देते हैं यू हैव टू ड्रॉ दैट पॉइंट ऑन द ग्राफ एज वेल आपने उनको यही बताना है एग्जामिनर को कि मैंने ग्राफ से देखा दो यू आर डूइंग द कैलकुलेशन पर आपने लिखना ऐसे ही है फ्रॉम ग्राफ इट इज क्लियर that when the distance is this, work done is this, right? So ये दो parts हमारे रह गए थे, इनको अच्छे से देख लो. So we'll start with question number 7. We will continue tomorrow as the period is kicked off, right? The bell has gone. So do these questions and send your notebook of 7th chapter for checking. Triangle. Okay? We'll meet tomorrow. Till then, take care.